Noel Gallagher. You might remember him from a little band called Oasis. Together with brother Liam, the Gallaghers were known as the kings of Britpop and spent the 90s dropping smash hit rock anthems that have well and truly stood the test of time. In 2009, the band finally called it quits, going their separate ways due to irreconcilable differences.
All I did was leave a band. That's all I did. You know, I didn't kill anybody yet.
He moved on with new band Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, who are celebrating the 10th anniversary of their debut record. To mark the occasion, they put together a best of with some brand new tracks. But in the meantime, here's Wonderwall. I said, maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me.
And Noel Gallagher joins us now from London. Noel, welcome back to the project.
Hello, how are you?
I'm very well. So I'm interested in the title that you've given this best of. So Back the Way We Came, Volume 1. So obviously, yeah. Best ofs are naturally back. Wood-looking, they're retrospective.
Yeah.
But are you trying to capture something kind of nostalgic?
That's what a best of is. It's kind of looking back over your journey so far. And the reason why it's called Volume 1 is when I came up with the title, I thought the title was so good that I'd be damned if I'm coming up with another one in another 10 years. So we'll just stick a Volume 1 on it and call the next one Volume 2.
You write all the songs for this project. You wrote them for Oasis as well. So looking back on all of that, what's the best song that you've ever written?
Well, it's either got to be a toss-up between the best, I don't know, but the most famous are Don't Look Back in Anger and Wonderwall. They're the ones that everybody in the world seems to know. Whether they're the best, I don't know. Everybody would have a personal opinion on that. My personal favourite, probably from the Oasis lot, would be Supersonic, which is our first single, because it was written and recorded and mixed in one night. So that holds a special place in the canon. But I'd say Don't Look Back in Anger, because when I play it every night, it brings the house down, and that song means a lot to people, and it probably means more than I'll ever understand, actually.
Are you pretty rapt that you were the one who got to sing Don't Look Back in Anger?
I was going to sing either one or the other. We went through a period of the singer would walk off stage regularly, like once every three gigs, you know, he'd kind of get in a bad mood with himself. And I'd be left to kind of finish the gig off, and I thought I'd better have some big tunes. And then everybody else thought it would be better if Liam sang Wonderwall, because I don't know why. And anyway, but it turned out great in the end.
I mean, surely Liam lost out of that one. You get the showstopper. Like, that is the song that everybody stops for.
I'd like to think so.
Yeah.
I'd like to think so.
I don't think there's much debate, is there?
I don't know, though. Wonderwall, I mean, that song, I mean, Lord knows what it's even about, but that song has paid for many a holiday.
I imagine you have a lot of wild stories from your life touring.
You have no idea.
Well, yes, I assume I have no idea. I heard, though, once you were deported from the Netherlands for getting in a brawl with some Chelsea supporters. Is that true?
I wasn't. Everybody else was. While they were fighting with football supporters, I was chatting up girls in the bar.
Right.
There's lots of stuff. I've been banned by the Chinese government from ever visiting China. I've forgotten that I did a gig for the Tibetan monks in Central Park. I was so high, I'd forgotten I did it. And then when it came to go to China, I got a letter from the Ministry of the Interior telling me I was an enemy of the people.
Wow.
Which is quite some achievement.
What's it like receiving a letter like that?
Funny. You know, because I like the food. You know what I mean? And it's kind of like, can't go there now.
Luckily, it is a cuisine that is widely available around the world. You should be OK.
Yeah, but you kind of like to go to the source, right?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Those early days with Oasis, do you look back fondly on those times?
Absolutely. Best times of my life. And they were great days, because you didn't know what was going to happen from one week to the next, but you knew that it was going to be bigger and bigger. Then after Morning Glory, all hell broke loose. And then at the end of the Morning Glory tour, we all got paid, and that's when the fun started.
If you loved it so much, why can't you go back?
People ask me that question on a daily basis, and I can only say to you that I just don't feel like it. I don't feel like it. When you're in a band, it's an absolute compromise. So where I'm at now, I don't think I could come up with an idea and have to run it by four people, and then 6 weeks later, somebody knocks it back because their cat's got a cough. So, you know, I like to march to the beat of my own drum. So, no, Oasis is done, I'm afraid.
Yeah, well, it's sad for all of us, although perhaps less so for you, I think.
Well, no. Listen, the legacy of the band is set in stone, and if people seen us, then they'll understand what all the fuss is about. If you didn't see us, then that's tough, because I never seen the Beatles or the Sex Pistols, so get over it.
I understand. I have to say, I'm someone who watches, you know, from a distance, but I'm just staggered with how often you end up talking about your, you know, your ongoing stoush and your situation with your brother. And I just feel at the end of it, can you just tell me that you love him, like, beneath it all?
Well, it's not me that ever starts the conversation.
Right.
Other people are fascinated by it, which is fascinating to me, but other than that, I don't really have a great deal to say about it.
It wasn't a yes. I was hoping for a yes, but I understand. I'll let you answer that however you like. I'm out of time, I'm afraid. I could keep talking to you for hours. It's been wonderful to speak to you.
Thank you very
much. Noel Gallagher, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.
And the album, of course, is Back the Way We Came, Volume 1. It's out on June the 11th.
Hey there, it's about time you finished that video. I contractually had to wait so I could tell you to subscribe. Subscribe. I'm waiting. Now I can go home. Woo!